And this is also the territory of and pride that I've spent a lot of time with. So if we don't find our cheetah, we could get lucky with lions, we could get lucky with all sorts of things. So if you have any questions on what it is we do or what you could see out here, remember we're live from Kenya. We will hopefully at some point be live from South Africa as well. So you actually get to experience two different African countries, all live and all happening right now. It is, of course, for you, first thing in the morning. Is that right? Yes, it is right. For us, it is late afternoon going on evening. Here we go. This is the spotted creature I found. It's not the spotted creature I was looking for. It's much taller than that. And there we go. There's actually quite a few of them around here, but we'll stop at the one closest. We've got two creatures here. One with spots and one with stripes. And they get really nice perspective on just how massive a giraffe truly is. If you think about a zebra being just a little bit bigger than a donkey, now you can compare and you can see just how large a giraffe is. Now that is a male giraffe that is standing there on the right. I know he's a male straight away, just basically having looked at his size. Then the next step is to have a look at the things on the top of his head. And I call them, well, I'm going to call them ossicones rather than horns, because giraffes are born with those things on the top of their heads. It's solid bone, and they're basically like horns. But the difference is that antelope are born without horns that grow. Now, if you kids who are watching are struggling to think of a question, perhaps there's something that you really like to know, but you're feeling a little bit shy, chat to your teacher, ask your teacher, and they will be able to pass the question along to us as well. You can see some giraffe in the background as well, and some zebra. So there's plenty to look at out here. And what you can probably hear, or at least probably see, is that the wind is howling. And that's because I think there is some serious rain that is slowly but surely blowing across in our direction. Hopefully it holds off before the end of your drive. I'm going to keep trying to escape it though. But before I do, we have a question coming through from Blake. Now, Blake, you want to know how tall a giraffe gets. Blake, you're looking at somewhere between around about 12 to 15 feet on average, but they can get even taller than that. They can make 18 feet in certain circumstances, in record-breaking circumstances, even over 18 feet, all the way from the ground to the top of their heads. That's a really massive animal, and it's difficult to get a sense of perspective because you're looking through the eyes of the camera, but they really, really are tall. And when they come and they stand next to the vehicle, it's when you really get an idea of just how tall they really are. And the reason that they are tall like that, well, one of the theories that's been put forward, if we have another look at him, we saw him earlier munching away on the leaves of the Balanites tree, which is that type of tree over there. That's one of the theories, is of course because then it means that giraffe can feed higher than any other giraffe. But there is another reason that giraffe have long necks, and probably actually the main reason why giraffe have long necks, and that's because they use them to fight each other. Now, giraffe are pretty peaceful animals. They're not territorial. They don't really get into major fights most of the time, but when a female is ready to mate and there are two big males competing for her, they will fight by swinging their heads around and hitting each other on the neck or on the shoulders, on the sides. And because they've got such long, very, very strong necks, those impacts are actually particularly powerful. And they can, in rare circumstances, even kill each other in fighting in that way. But that doesn't really happen all that much. There we go. We have a question from Frank W. Cox High School, and we do have quite a diverse group of ages joining us today. We've got two elementary schools and one high school. But a question from the high school is, do giraffe travel in herds? Yes, essentially, although it's not uncommon to see a giraffe on their own. So a giraffe is not like a lion. A lion will live together. Sorry, there's a fly that keeps trying to fly into my ear. It's driving me insane. They will live, a lion pride will live in a pride, the females, for essentially most of their lives, most likely. Whereas giraffe will form a herd, they'll come and go, sometimes they'll move off on their own, sometimes they'll wander around. But it's most common to see them together in a group, in a herd like this. And that proper collective noun, of course, is a journey of giraffe or a tower of giraffe. Dabriel, how fast can a giraffe run? Surprisingly fast. Imagine if you had legs that were over 2 meters long, over 6 feet long. And then think about how fast you'd be able to run. Now, they've got four of them. And it looks like when a giraffe runs in slow motion, it looks like, sorry, when a giraffe runs, it looks like it's running in slow motion. But they're actually covering ground incredibly quickly. And you're looking at around about a top speed 30 miles an hour. That's very, very fast. And most of the time, though, giraffe tend to stand and stare at a predator as a defense mechanism. Andy, again, you're actually looking at an animal that can live for quite a considerable period of time, well over 20 years in the wild, in the case of some of the older giraffe, especially female giraffe. So what you'll find for the most part out here is that most of the species, the females will live longer than the males. And that's because there tends not to be as much competition. It's not as dangerous for them. So provided they make it past their first year, which is when, of course, they are very small and quite vulnerable to something like a lion's, chances are their survival chances increase dramatically, and they can live to over 20 years old. Now, this is a big, dark male, and he's probably, I would say, over 10 years old. Kylie, yes, giraffe do eat things other than leaves. They are mainly browsers. That is basically the predominant thing that they eat. In fact, I would say that 95% of their diet is leaves. But they will occasionally eat seeds. They will also, I've seen a giraffe bend down and eat a little bit of grass, but that's very, very unusual. You wouldn't consider them to be a grazer. And they also practice something else, which is known as osteophagy. Now, it's not really eating bones properly. So osteophagy means the practice of eating bones. And what they do is they pick up bones off the ground, and it's actually really fun to watch. And they put them into their mouths and they chew around the edges. So they basically grind that outside layer away and they swallow that. And a lot of animals do it out here. Obviously, the hyenas and the lions, they'll eat bones as part of their diet. But a lot of the herbivores will do it to supplement their calcium and their phosphorus intake. Okay, so I mentioned earlier that I was planning on searching for a spotted cat. Well, you're in luck. I might not have found one, but Scott has.